In the spotlight this morning, get ready to laugh. From King of Queens to Family Guy, comedian Craig Gass is in town for a show at the Comedy Connection this weekend. And he joins us in studio this morning ahead of the big show. Good morning.
I just want to mount your face. I'm so happy to see you. I've been looking forward to seeing you for so long. And it's been so long since I've been to Providence. I don't know why it's taken me so long.
It's about 2 years?
It's been 5 years I come back semi-regularly to do a benefit show for the Station Fire Fund. So I've been doing shows with the Station Fire Fund. But it's been 5 years since I've come to do like a real long show at the Comedy Connection, which is weird because that place has always had a special place in my heart because it was the first place that ever booked me professionally.
Wow.
As a stand-up comedian like 18 years ago. They called me up. This is a great story. I always tell it on stage that they called me up and they said, hey, my name is so-and-so. I run the Providence Comedy Connection. And I understand that you're a dirty comedian. Is that true? And thinking that that was a bad thing, I said, well, it depends on, I mean, if it's a corporate gig, I will adjust my material. I had never done a corporate gig. I'm lying. I'm just lying. And the guy on the other end of the phone said, well, if you're dirty, you're perfect for Providence. And I always remember thinking, what is wrong with people in Providence? And every time I've come up, I've had amazing shows at the Comedy Connection.
You have had great shows. I've been to a bunch of your shows. We have been friends for a long time. And you know, not only, I mean, you're a funny guy. I'm a huge fan. I heard you on the radio yesterday. And if I didn't know it was you, you are amazingly talented when it comes to impressions.
Well, impressions have just been something that's been... This is not a joke. This is a true story. Everyone in my family is deaf.
Right.
My mom, my dad, my sister are all completely deaf. So growing up in that family, I couldn't learn how to speak for my own family. I learned how to talk by copying all the voices I heard on TV. So I've always been able to mimic any kind of voice that I hear. And I've been doing voices with Family Guy.
Sure.
And are you worried about what I'm going to say?
I'm very worried about what you're going to say.
I started doing voices with Family Guy a few years ago, which was great. I'm glad I'm still... I mean... I was nervous because the first episode of Family Guy that I worked on, I almost screwed the whole thing up.
Yeah.
Because I walked in, and I'm such a fan of Seth MacFarlane and of Family Guy that I got really nervous. We had a recording session that lasted maybe 5 minutes. It was Seth MacFarlane. He kept doing one voice. He kept doing one line as Peter Griffin, where he kept saying, "This is crazier than when Al Pacino was a slumlord laundromat tenant." And then they cut to me as Al Pacino in the middle of a bunch of broken down washers and dryers going, "You're out of order, and you're out of order, and you're all out of order!" And I did that 3 times, and Seth MacFarlane goes, "All right, man,
you got the game.
I think we're good." And I was so nervous because I thought we were going to be friends now that I said, "Hey, so you want to hang out at all?" And he goes, "What do you mean hang out?" And I go, "Oh, you want to grab a coffee or something?" He goes, "I got to work." And I go, "All right, do you want me to leave?" And he goes, "Yeah, I got the hell out of here." And I go, "Oh, I'm sorry. Sorry, let me get the papers." And I
quickly, because you're also part of a new show with Dana Carvey, Steve Carell, yes.
Steve Carell and Dana Carvey is a show called First Impressions. They're looking for the best celebrity impressionist in the country. So they said, "Can you do some new impressions?" And I said, "Okay." And when I do my new impressions, they're awful.
Right.
So when my friends look at me and go, "That doesn't sound like the guy." And I go, "Well, all right, that's not Arnold Schwarzenegger. That's Arnold Schwarzenegger after a bad car accident. That's why I can get away with, yeah, 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 yeah." So with that in mind, I don't do a Mark Wahlberg impression, but I do something called out of breath Mark Wahlberg.
Okay.
Okay? So I just need a situation that out of breath Mark Wahlberg can come running into. So give me a crazy situation.
Bring in this pizza.
What?
Bring in this pizza.
Okay, a pizza. Okay, here we go.
I'll be standing up.
All right, here we go. "Guys, are you serious? This pizza's been on fire. What are you doing, man? Come on, I'm sitting here with Will, and you're just sitting there, and you're doing nothing. Come on, feel it, feel it. Come on, come on." All right, that's it. That's a terrible impression.
Now,
that's out of breath Mark Wahlberg.
Tickets are for this weekend, right?
Yes, this weekend. It's ricomedyconnection.com. 2 shows Friday, 2 shows Saturday, and I'll keep working on my out of breath Mark Wahlberg.
That's okay. Impression. That's right. Before we wrap up, you said you have been working on an impression of me.
Yeah.
And I know last time it was scary good.
Yeah.
Would you be able to read what's on the teleprompter as we say goodbye?
Yeah, I'll do it right now. And keep in mind that my impression of Will is starting to sound like Tracy Morgan.
"All right, everybody. Well, that's it. My name's Will. I want to thank Craig, and you can see Craig Gass take the stage this Saturday night at the Comedy Connection. The show starts at 10:15. That's on Friday night, isn't it?"
Nice job.
I love this dude. He's crazy.